Hey everyone, I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer, and welcome back to another video. And in this one, I want to tell you guys how to make Civilization VI less boring. And this is a video related to, you all know it, those parts in the game where you spend zero time but building banks or building soldiers and doing absolutely nothing. You know, the beginning of the game is really active. You're always discovering new things. And about midway through, probably, if you are not going to attack someone by the time you unlock gunpowder, the game is really boring, right? So these are the things that I do to make the game less boring. First of all, activate quick movement and quick combat. Because, let me tell you, I activated it because it was affecting the performance of my live stream, and I think it cut my game time down from like 8 hours to 6.5 or 7. So you spend a lot of time watching people fight when the only reason you made them fight was to see the end result. Same thing with movement, you know? Now, if you're a new player, don't get rid of it, but if you're a even decent player and you can understand, oh, the elephant went from there, you don't have to see the animation, turn it off. It's a waste of your time. They're beautiful animations. And if you want to film cinematically, go for it, but Jesus, dude, turn it off. I hate it. Also, if you're playing on PC and you want your game to go by fast, turn your game on the lowest settings. It will make it process faster. That's a tip that I think not a lot of people think about, is the game, because, you know, 8 hours, the average game takes 8 hours. Cutting down a half hour of useless time out of those 8 hours, pretty good. Now, if you think about it, cut down a half hour from watching animations. I mean, you already get an hour of your time back, and you'll be able to get through more games faster, learn the game faster. Another thing that I would do is, when you're researching technology, okay, set it up. If you are playing and you're researching, let's just say you're like me and you go straight to ironworking unless something happens. Go in your tech tree, click ironworking. What that's going to do is that's going to make it so the game researches, you know, I don't even know what the first tech you need to research. And then it's bronze working, and then the other thing, ironworking. It will do it all and you won't have to go, okay, choose research. Click the thing. You know, you don't have to click it every time. You can also shift click stuff. So you can make a whole plan. You can spend a little bit of extra time making a whole plan so you don't have to keep pulling up this screen over and over and over and over again. Same thing with your civics. I mean, for me, I generally research the same beginning civics in the same exact order every time. So I just set that up so I don't gotta think about the civics tree for, like, ever. Automatic movement's a little bit different. Automatic movement you should avoid, because if you, like, go like, settler, go that way, 10 turns away. They might walk next to a barbarian camp, and then you have to go save them. So avoid that. Just don't touch it. Later on, when you have a big enough empire, as soon as you train a unit, if you know they're going to walk through friendly territory and not get oofed, then have them automatically go and march, you know. And then what I would do is, at some point, this is what Civ 6 kind of sucks at, is you have to micromanage all your cities. So if you're a big nation, let's just say you're playing on a super large map, you got 30 cities, you know, at some point, you have to decide, okay, I want a metagame. What's my metagame going to be? Like, what I do is, if I decide that I'm going to go to war, right, I'm busy moving all my troops around, I default into is a city. I make all, like, my 20 filler cities, which produce marketplaces and banks and stock exchanges, right? And you can queue those up. So you queue up market, bank, stock exchange. Use that queue tool. That queue tool is there to not only help you plan ahead, but to save you time. It saves you so much time. All right? Then I take my cities that I will know will produce units, and I just go shift. I do my queue. I'm like, infantry, just over and over and over again. Because I know at these big scale battles, you're going to lose troops, you're going to refill them anyway. So it's nice to not have to go, infantry, move, choose production, infantry. You know, I don't have to do that all the time. That's another way to speed up your game time. All of this, guys, is just learning hotkeys. Learn hotkeys. It will help you tremendously. Now, something that I do not do that I recommend that you guys do, if you can, is learn keyboard shortcuts, especially for builders, right? Instead of having to move your mouse around, you can just have a move, quick move to the spot you want to build a farm, push, I think it's I for farm, bam, farm. Those are all things that save you time. All of this is about saving you time, and it will make the game less boring, because then, you know, you don't have to spend 2 hours micromanaging every city. I know that the game likes to make you do that. Don't do it. Now, let's say you're at the end game, right? Now, this is, Civ 6 is terrible at end games, okay? But you're guaranteed at this point to win, okay? And all you gotta do is, let's just say, build a spaceship. You got, like, your space parts. You just gotta build, two more left, and it's gonna take you 10 turns. Now, if you're at the end of the game and you're like me, where you conquer everyone and then just do science victory just because why not, you probably got like 40 cities, okay? What I would do then, this is what I do all the time, is I find, obviously they're going to have buildings. So I take the city and I take and I set it to build nukes. I set every city just to build nukes or the commercial hub investment, or the, at that point you don't need science, so some sort of hub investment, one of the districts, one of the district investments, or nuclear weapons. And that's just so you don't have to spend time micromanaging all your cities, because at that point you gotta wait 10 turns, build the spaceship, you win, right? 20 turns, 30 turns, build the spaceship, you win, you know? Especially on like marathon mode, when sometimes you have really powerful cities that can build stuff really, 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 really fast. And you gotta sit there, 100 turns to build a spaceship, you're gonna win, and this infantry unit gets built every 5 turns. Because you broke the game. You don't gotta sit there and build 20 infantry units, make a move and fortify. No. At that point, if you do decide to go for a science win, just stop conquering. Just set all your units to fortify in defensive locations. Or if you've crippled enough people, just fortify everything, you know? But quick movement, I don't remember if it affects airplanes. If you want to save time, don't use airplanes. Whatever you do. The airplanes in this game, you have to watch them and it's like, and then they bomb and then they go back. I remember quick movement. I don't remember if it affects airplanes because I haven't used airplanes because airplanes suck. But airplanes, I remember airplanes taking up half my turn. 8 bomber planes taking up half my turn. 8 units. That's all I have. Without quick movement on, without quick combat on, they're just... It's so annoying. So that's my tips on how to make Civ 6 less boring. If you're a professional, at that point, the only way to make it less boring is to either play with other people or try the most retarded, stupid strategies. Like only using slingers. It's a good thing. You should try. I haven't tried it. You're gonna die. Don't use slingers. Archers are better. So that's all I got. What kind of tips do you have to make Civilization 6 less boring? I know I usually only play the game on quick mode, but that makes me miss out a lot. Especially on using units like Pikemen and Pike and Shot. I don't really tend to pull those out very much. And I tend to miss out on using Horsemen. So, if you play it on quick, just know you're going to miss out on content in the game. So that's all. That's all I got for you guys to make Civilization 6 less boring. I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer. I suck just as bad as you do at video games. And I'll see you guys in the next one.